All right, in the hurry click of business ideas, oh my goodness, my mother was, you know, in her like incredible disoriented state most of the time. She did try to make orientated ideas. So here we have like hogalog. Now this type of thing would be an idea here for the United States to open up a hedgehog center. Or if they don't have hedgehogs here, maybe they have the raccoons, something local, squirrels, chipmunks, and people then donate. So you run it, and then people donate money to you, and then they go visit them. It's kind of like a little small zoo, but not a zoo, just native animal visits. So that's an idea. And the people adopt. They adopt a hedgehog, they adopt, so think of that idea. No hedgehogs here, but possums, adopt a possum, that type of deal. You know, because it's fun near the city. All of these things are fun near the city for city people. And, you know, just have these little fun. This is something done in Britain quite often. And I believe they're profitable enough. It makes a living for people. So what else do I have? Oh my gosh, I have three of those. Yeah, so she did. She would, you know, a lot of writings. A tiny dairy farm. Now, it's when you have a tiny dairy farm, it would be very small. Just for maybe one or two things, like maybe two goats, maybe one like a yak. And one cow, and that's it. Just a very, very small dairy farm, very tiny, and just for a few local pickups, and that's it. So that's a kind of a cute idea. And so you become like a member for your fresh milk. And somehow it's a cooperative that it bypasses the fact of it needing homogenization and all of that other. And that's your own disclosure that you sign on the terms of agreement. If you die because you drank the unhomogenized milk, then you die. So yeah. So but that would be another cute idea. So we have to think of those for, because I think there's like not a lot of fun going on here in that direction at all. So we have to think of those new fun ways to. It's kind of like we have to be catchy and teasy to remember nature, to remember conservation. I was looking through all of these writings of my mother's, and there's so much of it is just like bamming hard on the head, you know, to the people, and I don't think they respond well to it. I do not think human beings are responding well to the eco ecologists as being aggressors. It just has not been working. I believe they really, maybe that's it. You know, maybe that's all the humans can really handle right now is just like Britain, these little hedgehog society organizations, you know, join and adopt a hedgehog, you know, or maybe go and have your own raw milk, you know, just down the road. You know, yet in a city environment, so that's kind of fun, you know. Or go pick up your fresh eggs. You know, you could have that also. So they may cost a fortune, you know, $15 for your batch of fresh eggs, but it does not matter. Does not matter, does it? It's just the fact that you're a member of that particular organization, cooperative. You get to name that chicken or that hen, and that gets to be your life input helper, you know. So you have like that personal, what do you call that, agrément, that personal feeling of hey, you know, I always wanted to be on the farm, but I can't, and yet you can have that in touch moment, you know, and be there. So that's something that we're missing here in the cities, something missing, and it's good for the children. It's good for the adults. It's a healer. It's a healer for everybody. Okay?